These are the big stories for last week.
Talking about security, Nigeria is in very safe hands. Talking about security, I want to use this opportunity to assure all Nigerians that despite the security challenges we are facing now, Nigeria is in very safe hands.
On insecurity, the Minister of Information, Lai Mohammed, said Nigeria is in safe hands. Most times, the words of the Minister of Information has always given us a misinformation because we don't always understand whatever it means. Because even after making such a statement, that same day, there was a report of about 36 people killed in Benue State, and there was an hashtag on Twitter that saved Benue. It has been reported that a lot of killings are going on in Benue State, and it has been underreported. So we don't really know in which safe end the Minister of Information was actually referring to, that Nigeria are in safe hands. The southern governors came together last week to put a ban on open grazing in their state. And this has actually raised a lot of eyebrows from leaders in the north, with the presidency also responding to such developments. So the presidential aide, Garba Shehu, saying the decision of the southern governors to ban open grazing is of questionable legality. This response actually also led a lot of criticism from Afeniferi Group, the southern governors, and a lot of senior advocates of Nigeria, that what the presidency said about the issue is not meant to be said. And in a response to doubt the criticism, the presidency comes back to say that the presidency is actually against open grazing. All this was said by the presidential aide. And in another response, our senior advocate of Nigeria, Femi Falana, said even though the development is meant to take effect from the month of June, that there is no preparation, there is no single identified ranch that has been prepared for the Fulani herdsmen to actually cater for their cows. And he also said that around 2016, that the federal government actually said it has acquired about 55,000 hectares of land in about 11 states of the federation. But till now, there has not been an identified ranch in the nation. So how is this development going to be possible is what he actually raised concern about. A bill seeking to scrap the NYC shame has just passed the second reading in the Nigeria House of Senate. And in a response by the Minister of Transport, he said the federal government is actually behind the shame and it's not him to scrap the shame. But the actions of the House of Senate goes in contrary with what he believes the federal government wants to do, simply because the bill has just passed the second reading and we will soon see the end of the bill. And if the NYC actually is for what it is said to be, I don't think there is any need for the government to scrap it. It was said to be a form of empowerment to the SAID program and also a form of service to the father's land. The earliest part of the week, a lot of Nigerians actually criticized President Muhammadu Buhari for not attending the burial ceremony of the former chief of staff who was late, Major General Atayo Ibrahim. And in a response to this, Garba Shehu said, even though he hasn't spoken to the president about his absence, but he gives opinion that it might be because the president doesn't like to molest the ordinary citizen, because the president doesn't want the roads to be cleared for him to make passage, and because it's a mourning moment for the people who actually came to the burial. He doesn't want to draw their attention. What he was trying to say is that President Muhammadu Buhari does not attend the burial of the late chief of staff simply because he doesn't want to draw attention to himself, and he doesn't want to molest ordinary Nigerians simply because he views that clearing the road for the president might actually be in a path to actually molest the Nigerians. And that was why President Muhammadu Buhari did not attend the burial. Of course, this doesn't go well with many Nigerians, as they believe this was just a cover-up story. Now let's go for a short break and we'll be back very shortly. Let's check this viral video. It was something out of nothing that Nigeria actually made a deal out of the money pool of. And then that's also going to become a challenge. Let's see the video. So welcome back. In another development, another news over the week, police arrest a soldier who allegedly killed a civilian who gave him a ride in Akwa Ibom State. The civilian gave the military officer a ride on the May 23rd from in Akwa Ibom, and then after a while, the military man actually pounced on him in an attempt just to steal his car. He killed him and dispossessed him of his car, and he dumped his body by the roadside. And the police were actually drawn to the scene, and they took the body to the mortuary, and then the relatives of the man actually lodged the report, and they were able to track the car. When they tracked the car, they found it at another area of Akwa Ibom State, and then that was where the soldier who killed the man was arrested. It's a very sad news. I pray God help us in this nation. How can you give a public officer a ride? It's very right, very benevolent to give them a ride, and you still lose your life in the process. Another development, the Attorney General of the Federation of Malawi was quizzed by an ad hoc committee of the House of Representatives, citing a letter from his office that he collected a sum of 2 billion naira from the recovered loot with an attempt to use the money to fund some terror case. But in a response to this development, the Attorney General of the Federation actually said he has no link to such a letter, and that such a letter never came from his office, and that he never collected any money from the recovered loot. That CBN has a special account that is meant for the recovered loot, and he never collected such money from the CBN. So thank you very much. That's all for the big stories that we have for you today. Hope to see you next week again for a summary of the big story that we have for the week. Hope to see you. Thank you very much. Kindly like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.